Stunning pushback from the office of the First Lady Melania Trump directed at her husband's personal attorney, Rudy Giuliani. As you know, Giuliani was brought on board just last month to be aggressive, a flamethrower, and defend the president against his legal troubles. He's certainly living up to that and right now under fire tonight from the First Lady's team. This all started earlier today at a conference in Tel Aviv where Giuliani was asked how Mrs. Trump feels about allegations from Stormy Daniels that she had an affair with the president back in 2006. Here's how Giuliani responded.
She believes in her husband. She knows it's untrue. I don't even think there's a slight suspicion that it's true when you, excuse me, but when you look at Stormy Daniels. I know Donald Trump and look at his three wives, right? Beautiful women, classy women, women of great substance. Stormy Daniels.
Now, the First Lady might have remained quiet about Mr. Giuliani saying she believes in her husband and knows it's not true, but instead, this afternoon, her communications director came out with a statement, quote, "I don't believe Mrs. Trump has ever discussed her thoughts on anything with Mr. Giuliani." CNN's Dana Bash has talked with Rudy Giuliani to get his reaction to all this. She joins me now along with CNN chief legal analyst Jeffrey Toobin. Dana, I just find this story fascinating. I mean, first of all, how unusual is it, before we get to what Giuliani has told you, how unusual is it that the First Lady's office put out a statement basically slapping him down?
So unusual. I mean, Anderson, it's unusual for the First Lady's office in any White House to put out a statement on anything of this nature, even if they were talking about a political foe. This is far from that. I mean, this is the First Lady's office, as you said, slapping down the president, her husband's attorney, for something that he said in a public forum on a global stage about her, sort of saying what he thinks that she feels or what she believes. And, you know, so she's basically saying to him, cut it out. But she's also sending a signal in the very carefully worded statement that maybe she doesn't believe her husband. And there's no question that she left it open to interpretation, as she does in so many different venues and so many different ways.
Right. You can read the statement in multiple ways, but I mean, it's
exactly.
Certainly a slap down of Giuliani, essentially don't put words in my mouth. Don't say what I'm thinking.
Yeah, no question. And you mentioned that I talked to him, Anderson. I did. And I said, how did you take it? And what he said is the following. He said, I took it, meaning Melania Trump's statement, as she didn't want to get involved and get called as a witness or anything like that. Then he went on to say, I think she is saying, please don't say that I said anything because I didn't. That's the freedom of being a lawyer. That's my interpretation. Now, he also said to me that he had never interviewed, that's the word he used, interviewed Melania Trump about this, meaning he never talked to her about it, that he was sort of just saying what he thinks that she believes. He also said that he's still in Israel, so we spoke basically in the middle of the night his time earlier this evening. He said that he has not heard from the president nor anyone in the White House, including Melania Trump, with an angry call or any call at all about his statements.
Does what is going on with Rudy Giuliani?
Well, I think this is really a question for a psychiatrist more than a legal analyst. I mean, he's just sort of riffing out there.
Because, I mean, from a legal standpoint, a wife isn't going to be called in to testify against her husband.
Right. I mean, she has privileged anything he might have said to her, and her opinion about whether this affair took place would certainly not be legally relevant other than any communication she would have had. So, I mean, that's just an argument of no substance. But, I mean, this is a pattern with Giuliani. I mean, he keeps making things up and representing subjects that he has no knowledge of. I mean, the same day, Secretary of State Pompeo slapped Giuliani down because Giuliani said, Kim Jong-un came begging and crawling back to the summit. And Pompeo said, well, he doesn't speak for us in foreign policy. So he's just out there riffing on television. And I don't think anyone is at this point paying a lot of attention.
And Dana, didn't Giuliani also say something about that Stormy Daniels doesn't have any credibility, but there may be others out there who do?
Listen, he has been very clear in saying that she doesn't have any credibility. I mean, that was really the initial big headline from this event that he did in Israel. And one of the things that he said, Anderson, and he's made that clear a number of times, is the reason he doesn't believe that Stormy Daniels is telling the truth is basically because she's not his kind of woman. He has said that publicly, and he also said to me that he believes that she, meaning Melania Trump, knows him well enough to know on this one, what's the word, fakakta. That's a Yiddish word. He's in Israel, so maybe he's having a when in Rome moment, but he's basically saying, and I'll translate it for you, that even Melania Trump thinks with this allegation from someone like Stormy Daniels, who he's described in very negative terms, she just doesn't believe it. Again, this flies in the face of what Melania Trump, through her spokesperson, said today in very abrupt terms and blunt terms that he doesn't speak for her.
Jeff, is Giuliani having the kind of week that would help with his credibility in terms of Robert Mueller? Well, that was supposedly the reason he was brought
on. I don't think Robert Mueller's office cares a whit about this stuff he says on television. This is just theater. I think some of what Giuliani says, the theatrical aspects of it, probably appeals to his client, Donald Trump. I mean, I think Giuliani is out there, you know, being outrageous and being definitive and saying that the Mueller people are trying to frame Donald Trump. I bet the president loves that. So I don't think Giuliani is in trouble with his client. Just in terms of the rest of us listening to what he says, you know, I think we've learned to take it with a grain of salt and then some.